We know that the digital data, that generally we also called as binary data in the form of zeros and ones, are normally transmitted in serial fashion. So in this serial fashion, there it is a pulse train. Here you see. So in this pulse train, we have the amplitude levels at the constant levels, plus 1 and minus 1. And here we are having A0, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 as the samples in general we can say on the time axis. So A0 is having plus 1 value, A1 having minus 1 value. So either you can have it plus and minus values or 1 and zeros. So it is just the representation of the binary data. So here you see the pulse train with clear amplitude levels at all the time on the time axis here. While such a signal is being transmitted from transmitter section, and that it receives to the intended destination, and after traveling through the communication channel, let us assume that the pulse train, that is obviously practically will be having the noise effect in lowering down few of the amplitude levels leading to the losses here. So the pulse train that will arrive at the receiver may be possibly of this particular type here. So what it was, the square wave here, it may have got distorted to this sinusoidal form, or in general little bit random form here, where it is quite possible to judge whether the amplitude level was there in the positives or negatives here, but with some sort of distortion here. So to work with this particular problem that is encountered having the transmission data as a pulse train, the frequency division multiplexing, that also we have discussed in the previous topic, the FDM with the overlapping sub channels can be the option here. In such of the systems here, each binary data, here we have AR in general denotation, so R is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on up to capital N minus 1, that will have the modules, a subcarrier sinusoidal signal cosine 2 pi RT divided by the time period capital T. So that we can visualize in this particular figure. So as we had the first illustration to show you the serial binary data stream A0, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5. Next to that, the baseband serially transmitted signal at the receiver with little bit of the distortions here. And now you see here the signals, those have been generated by modulating a set of subscribers, subcarriers by the digits of the pulse train in the first illustration, that it was A0, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, total 6 samples here. So here you see the variation for the amplitude versus the time in all these particular plots. So here the modulated subcarriers, as you see here, are summed up and further transmitted as one composite analog signal, and finally at the receiver the analog signal is passed through a bank of coherent demodulators whose outputs are tested for determining the digits transmitted here. So this is the basic idea behind the multi-carrier modulation or demodulation scheme for digital data transmission. And as we have a widely used form of such a modulation, that is the discrete multi-tone transmission, that we can abbreviate to as DMT here. So our topic, multi-tone transmission of digital data. So in the discrete domain here we have to refer for, and the abbreviation is DMT scheme, in which the modulation and demodulation processes are implemented via the use of DFT, standing for the discrete Fourier transform we have already seen. For efficiently realizing, the use of FFT can also be there, the same form. So let us have the basic idea behind the DMT scheme illustrated with the help of the example, where we assume that A suffix K of N and B suffix K of N, where K is greater than or equal to 0 but less than or equal to M minus 1, is a 2 capital M minus 1 real value data sequence operating at the sampling rate of capital FT that we have to be transmitted here. And let us define a new set of complex sequences as you see. A suffix k of n having the length n is equal to twice capital M according to the relation here. So we have a suffix k of n. For k is equal to 0, it will be a 0 of n. For k between 1 and n by 2 minus 1, it will be aq of n plus j times bq of n. For k is equal to n by 2, it will be b0 of n. And for k between n by 2 plus 1 and n minus 1, it will be a suffix n minus k of n minus j times bn minus k of n here. So let us apply the inverse discrete Fourier transformation, and the above set of n sequences will be transformed into the another new set of capital N signals as denoted by u suffix l of n here. So here it is the representation in the RHS. You see 1 upon capital N multiplied to the summation operation for k is equal to 0 to capital N minus 1. For alpha suffix k, or we have treated it to be a suffix k of n, multiplied to w suffix n to the superscript we have minus lk. So l is greater than or equal to 0 but less than or equal to capital N minus 1, so that it is the weight or the twiddle you can consider. So at the receiver, the received analog signal can generally be denoted as y of t will be passed through analog anti-aliasing filter and further converted into a digital signal y of n by the sample and hold circuit, which will be followed by analog to digital conversion operating at the rate capital N times the sampling rate Ft, that is equal to twice Fc in general. So now applying the discrete Fourier transformation to these capital N number of times the signals, we finally arrive at capital N signals denoted by beta suffix k of n, that is equal to the summation l is equal to 0 to capital N minus 1 for v suffix l of n multiplied to capital W suffix capital N. In the superscript we have lk for k greater than or equal to 0 but less than or equal to capital N minus 1. So let us visualize one figure that will schematically show the overall DMT scheme here, the discrete multitone transmission scheme. So we shall first of all see the transmitter section. Here it is. So we start at alpha 0 of n, alpha 1 of n, up to alpha suffix capital N minus 1 of n. Then the use of n point inverse discrete Fourier transformation. Then the next structure as you see. Then D to A converter, low pass filter, and X suffix A of t given to the channel. This is the transmitter section, and next to that we have the receiver section of this discrete multitone transmission system. So from the channel, whatever the signal will be received can be denoted as y suffix a of t, paired as input to the low pass filter as discussed, then sample and hold circuit, a to d converter, and the further circuitry you see having n point DFT in the use, finally arriving with beta 0 of n, beta 1 of n, in general up to beta suffix n minus 1 of n here. So if we have assumption of the frequency response of the channel to have a flat pass band and assume that the analog reconstruction and anti-aliasing filters to be ideal of low pass type, then neglecting the non-ideal effect of D to A conversion and A to D conversion, we can have assumption of y of n is equal to x of n. Hence, the interleaving circuitry of the discrete multitone transmission structure at the transmitting end connected to the D interleaving circuit at the receiving end will be identical. So from the equivalent representation, here we have Vk of n is equal to mu suffix k minus 1 of n minus 1 for k greater than or equal to 0 but less than or equal to capital N minus 2. V0 of n is equal to u suffix n minus 1 of n. In another words, we can also express it to the form beta suffix k of n equal to alpha suffix के माइनस वन ऑफ एन माइनस वन, के इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू जीरो बट लेस देन और इक्वल टू कैपिटल एन माइनस टू, बीटा सफिक्स जीरो ऑफ एन इज इक्वल टू अल्फा सफिक्स कैपिटल एन माइनस वन ऑफ एन. So the transmission channels in general will have the bandpass frequency response with a magnitude response dropping to zero at some frequency, and in some of the cases in the passband of the channel the magnitude response will instead be being a flat one will drop very rapidly outside its passband here. So let us visualize it into this particular illustration. Magnitude versus the frequency axis here we have, and here it is the representation of the frequency response for the bandpass filter denoted by capital H suffix CH of F here. So for reliable digital data transmission over such a channel and its recovery at the receiving end, the channel's frequency response needs to be compensated by essentially a high pass equalizer at the receiver.